Welcome to the next tutorial on electric power system. We are going to discuss the per unit system. Let us revise some of the important formulas that will be used to solve the problems. The first formula is to determine the base impedance. So the base impedance is basically the ratio of square of the kilovolt base square divided by MVA base. This formula will give rise to this formula. So Z per unit nu is equal to Z per unit given. So given some book, it can be used as old values. So MVA nu by MVA given into kilovolt given by nu whole square. So if we know these two formulas, it will be sufficient to solve the problem on a per unit system. Let us see the first problem. So if you have a three phase generator with rating 1000 kVA, 33 kilovolt, as its armature resistance and synchronous reactance as 20 ohm per phase and 70 ohm per phase respectively. So calculate the per unit impedance of the generator. So here we have to calculate the per unit impedance. So first we have to choose a proper base and then we have to find the per unit impedance. So we can choose the generator rating as the base KV and base KVA. So base KV we can choose at 33 kilovolt, which is the base KV for the generator. And KVA base we can choose as 1000. Then we know the formula for base impedance is kilovolt base whole square divided by MVA base. So here we have kilovolt base is 33 KV, which is equal to 33 KV square divided by MVA base. So convert this KVA into MVA by dividing with 1000. So we are getting a value of 1089 ohms. Now the actual impedance per phase is basically given to us, which is equal to 20 plus J70 ohm. Per phase. So this is the resistance and this is the reactance. Then the per unit impedance is basically the formula is actual impedance by base impedance. So actual impedance is 20 plus J70, which you put in the numerator, and in the denominator the base values will be there. So base value is 1089. We can observe one thing here is that although the actual value is in complex quantity, the base value is always real. So this gives you the per unit impedance of the generator. Problem number two, we have a three phase delta star transformer with rating 1100 kVA, 11 kV by 400 volt. So this is the primary voltage, this is the secondary voltage, and we see that this is a step down transformer. So its primary and secondary leakage reactances are given. So it is 12 ohm per phase and 0.05 ohm per phase respectively. Calculate the per unit reactance of the transformer. So we have been given the transformer is delta star connected and the KVA rating is given and the voltage rating of the primary and secondary is given. Also the leakage reactances are given. So you have to calculate the per unit reactance of the transformer. Now we'll take two cases. Case one, when high voltage winding or the primary rating is chosen as the base value, let us see what will happen. And in the case two, we'll take the low voltage winding rating as the base value. So seeing from the high voltage winding, so base KV is 11 KV and KV base is 100 KVA. So base impedance per phase, we determine it kilovolt base whole square, that is 11 KV square divided by convert this power base into the MVA. So divide it with 1000. So you get a base impedance of 1210 ohms. Now transformer line voltage ratio we have to determine. So seeing the voltage of the transformer on the primary and the secondary side, we can determine what is the transformer line voltage ratio. So 400 volt divided by 11 kV. So it is equal to 0.0364. Now total leakage reactance, which is referred to the primary side. So one of the side we have to refer to, let us refer to the primary side, because the primary side is the high voltage side and we are basically taking the base values from the primary side. So X01 is equal to total leakage reactance from the primary side is primary reactance, and secondary reactance refer to the primary side. So that is equal to X2 by K square, where a K square is basically the transformation ratio square. So X1 is given to be 12 and K is given found to be 0.0364, where X2 is 0.05. So the value which is coming here is basically 49.737 ohm per phase. Now we can determine the per unit reactance per phase. Is total leakage reactance, which we have got it 49.737 divided by the base impedance, which we have determined as 1210. So it is coming to be 0.0411 per unit. Now, in the next case, we will take the low voltage winding, that is the secondary rating, as the base value. So, base kilovolt we will take as 0.4 kV, and kVA base is same, is 100 kVA. Now, Z base we try to determine. So, it is equal to 1.6 ohm corresponding to kV base square divided by MVA base. And then transformer ratio is same, whatever was found earlier. Now, this transformation ratio will be used to determine the total leakage reactance referred to the secondary side. Now, X02 is the total leakage reactance referred to the secondary side. So, secondary leakage reactance plus the primary leakage reactance referred to the secondary side. So, it is equal to K square X1. So, after doing this calculation, we will get 0.0659 ohm per phase. So, now determine the per unit reactance. So, the actual value divided by the base value of the impedance. So, here you have 0.0659, that is the leakage reactance which we have determined, divided by the base impedance. So, base impedance is 1.6. So, we are getting a value of 0.0411 per unit. Now, what is there to be noted is, it is observed that the per unit reactance of transformer referred to primary and secondary side are same. So, whether you are calculating the per unit reactance from the primary side or secondary side, you will get reached to the same answer. Also, if a transformer is three-phase transformer of the voltage ratio K is obtained using line values, then using this value of K, the phase impedance per phase of star side can be directly transferred to delta side or vice versa. So, if the transformer is single phase transformer, there is no problem. But if the transformer is three phase transformer, so we have to use the voltage ratio K so that the delta star transformer is appropriately converted to find the per unit reactance. However, the per unit reactance, whether you determine from the primary side or secondary side, will be the same. Now, problem number three. You have to use the per unit system and taking into account the transformer percentage impedance, solve for the current in each part of the three phase system shown below. Assume both transformers are either delta delta or star star connected, and that there is no phase shift between the primary and secondary current and voltage. So, here we have been given a single line diagram of a power system where we have two transformer T1 and T2, and there is a transmission line and a load. So, this is a bus, three phase 60 hertz, 13.8 kV bus is there. Now, we have to determine what is the current in each part of the circuit. So, here we will be using the concept of per unit system. So, this problem will clear a lot of doubts regarding the per unit system, and the rating of both the transformers are given to us. So, let us see. We will solve this problem step by step basis. Let us take the step 1. So, in the step 1, we separate by voltage zones. So, entire single line diagram, you have to separate by voltage zone. So, where is the voltage changing? The voltage is changing wherever there is a transformer. So, basically, we have two voltage zones. One is a transformer T1 and other is a transformer T2. Now, assign the base values. And we know that base values will change when there is a change in the voltage. So, change in the voltage will accompany when there is a transformer. So, here let us concentrate on the first zone, this is the second zone, and this is the third zone. So, if you concentrate on the first zone, we see that we take a base impedance, base power of 45 MVA, which is the power of the transformer T1, and the base voltage as 13.8 kV. So, this is for the zone 1. Now, in the zone 2, due to the presence of the transformer, there will be a change in the voltage. So, the power, although it is 45 MVA, there is a change in the base voltage, which is equal to 69 kV, because on the transformer secondary side, it is 69 kV. Now, if we come to the zone 3, the base impedance, base power, it is 45 MVA, which is constant throughout the system. Now, the base voltage will change, because this transformer voltage 13.8 kV is on the secondary side. So, in this way, we have to choose a proper base for each particular zone. Now, after choosing the zone, we have to determine the base impedance for each zone. So, this is zone number 1, this is zone number 2, and this is zone number 3. So, we have been given the base power and base voltage for each zone. So, corresponding to that, you determine the base impedance for that particular zone by the formula KV base whole square divided by MVA base. So use the formula and determine the base impedance for each zone separately. Now after doing this, you have to determine the per unit impedance of each zone. So here this part, your per unit impedance will be equal to 1 because the actual value and base values are same. So we have to concentrate from this zone. So here you determine the per unit impedance. So per unit impedance is basically the actual impedance divided by the base value. So actual impedance of the line is 5 plus J15, which is the actual impedance, divided by the base value that you have calculated, which is equal to 105.8 that you put, and then determine the what is the line per unit impedance. Similarly, you have to do in the zone number 3. So zone number 3, the actual value is 200 ohms, which you have to put in the numerator, and base impedance you have already determined, which you put in the denominator. So basically you will get what is the per unit impedance of the load. Now you have completed the entire power system network in terms of the per unit value. So here you have a transformer T1 and here you have transformer T2, which is separated by a line whose per unit impedance is given. And here you have the per unit impedance of the load, and both transformer you have already calculated. So calculate the Z per unit of transformer T1. Now we have to calculate the per unit impedance of transformer T1 and T2 separately. So we have to see what is the per unit impedance. So here when there is a transformer, so transformer is just separating two particular zones. So concentrate on this side and this side of the transformer so that we concentrate for transformer T1. So transformer T1, here you have the base power as 45, base voltage as 13.8, and ZB you have calculated as 4.232. This side, secondary side of the transformer, the base power is 45 MVA, which is constant, base voltage is 69 kV, and you have determined the base impedance as 105.8. So since there is a change in the base, we have to use the formula Z per unit new and what is the relationship with Z per unit old. So basically when we are going from this side to this side, so Z per unit old or given is 5%. And you have to determine what is the, for the 5%, which is the Z per unit old, what is the Z per unit new corresponding to the MVA base and the KV base. So you use the formula, so you'll get a per unit impedance will be J0.05. So this is what we are doing for transformer T1 to determine the per unit impedance. Similar process we are going to do for transformer T2. Now concentrate on transformer T2 on both sides, this sides and this side. So these are the data corresponding to the, what we say, this primary side or the 69 kV side, and 13.8 kV side we have the this rating. So we have got the base power, base voltage and base impedance we have determined both on the primary side and secondary side of the transformer, and 4.6% is basically the per unit impedance old or given data. So corresponding to 4.6%, which is the old or given data, you determine what is the per unit impedance of the new using the formula that was discussed in the revision. So you will get a value of 0.0828. So Z per unit new is equal to Z per unit old into your formula for MVA base and KV base you have to use. You'll get a value 0.0828. Now we can see that we have determined the impedance. So after determining the impedance, we can easily determine what is the value of the current and what is the value of the voltage, since we have completed the entire power system network in terms of the per unit value. So we have determined for the transformer T1, transformer T2, this is for transmission line, and this is for the load, right? And this is the entire single line diagram. So let us concentrate on the first particular zone. So this is our first zone. So in the first zone, your base impedance was, base voltage was 13.8 kV. So per unit voltage we have to determine. So per unit voltage is equal to actual value by base value. So we'll get a 1 per unit in the zone number 1. So here the entire current that is flowing I per unit is basically the total voltage per unit divided by the total impedance. So total impedance, we can just sum up the impedance of transformer T1 plus transmission line plus impedance of transformer T2 plus impedance of load. So this will give you the total per unit impedance of the entire power system network. So voltage per unit divided by Z per unit will give you the current. So this is the current which is being originated from the system. Then you can use the Ohm's law to calculate the per unit current. So here we have got the voltage to be 1 per unit, and the total impedance we have to calculate by adding up these values. Okay, after adding up these values, we can determine the per unit impedance, per unit current. So per unit current is equal to per unit voltage, which is 1 per unit, divided by the total impedance. So Z per unit is basically total R per unit plus J time X per unit. So total resistance and total reactance are separated out each other, and we have to determine the total current. So current will have a magnitude as well as you have an angle. Now you have to calculate the base current in each zone. So since we have been divided with the each zone, you have to determine the base current, and the current in a particular zone will be the per unit value into the base value. So per unit value we have already calculated, you multiplied with the base value of the network for a particular zone. So we have first zone, second zone and third zone. This will give you the current in the particular zone. So we know that actual value is equal to per unit value into base value. Per unit value we have already calculated, which is equal to the per unit voltage, which is equal to 1 per unit divided by the total impedance of the network, which we have calculated. Now we will determine the current. So here concentrate on the first zone. So in the first zone, we have been given the base power and the base voltage. So base current we have to determine. So which is equal to power base divided by root 3 times the base voltage. So this is the base current. Now it is a three phase system, so we are using root 3 term. So similarly, we will be calculating for zone number 1, zone number 2 and zone number 3. So everywhere we have been determined the current which is flowing in terms of the base value. So if we have calculated the current in terms of base value, we can calculate the actual current in each zone. So actual current in each zone is basically the base value that we have calculated multiplied with the per unit value. Per unit value throughout the system is constant. Then you multiply the base value for each zone with respect to the base value that you have calculated for each zone with the per unit value. Then you will get the current which is flowing in each particular zone of the network. So that will have a magnitude as well as direction. Now, afterwards, the final step you can calculate and check in terms of transformation ratio whether the current that you have calculated is right or wrong. Since there is a transformer which is having a transformation ratio, so in terms of transformation ratio, we can check whether the current on the primary side and the secondary side are equal in terms of the transformation ratio K. So here we can see that the current in the 13.8 kV side is this much, and on the 69 kV side the current is this much. So use the formula of transformation ratio to check whether the transformation ratio in terms of the voltage and transformation ratio in terms of the current are same. So having checked that for transformer T1 and T2, if it is correct, then the solution is correct and you have determined all the current and voltage in the all the parts of the system single line diagram correctly. So in this way we can solve any problem based on the per unit value, and that give an advantage because whether you take a transformer primary side or secondary side, it doesn't matter. Thank you for now, and we'll see you in the next tutorial. Thank you.